for your head. I'll get you up and going out of bed.
Well, that is it. Very, very busy day today and yesterday, getting everyone checked in and set up. You know, all the team members, all Scottish team members are back in the gyms this week. So very, very buzzing and some great results from everyone. You know, to everyone on the team, if you're watching this, you smashed this lockdown. Massive well done. And now I can just sit and get excited because I've done all the check-ins. So I'm not doing them tomorrow morning and I am absolutely buzzing.
Surprising my boyfriend after 4.5 months apart in lockdown. I had to get his flatmate's keys to get in. Good secured.
I follow you into the park, through the jungle, through the dark. God, I never loved one like you. Boats and boats and waterfalls, alleyways and payphone calls. I'll
why
be
there
never
he is.
With you. We laugh until we think we'll die, barefoot on a summer night. Nothing new is sweeter than with you.
Shukas.
I've got to start the video off now. She told me that she was getting in tomorrow morning. You fucking surprised me. I haven't seen you in 4.5 months. You're such a dick though. Oh my god.
I got you.
I was literally just sitting like there doing the check-ins. And I was just talking to Instagram and then she just, oh, I thought it was Dylan. Fucking hell. I still actually don't think you're here. Oh my god, fuck. The last lockdown date night.
Fuck Zoom dates.
Zoom dates are absolutely terrible. No one can
fuck
tell me
them.
Different. Honestly, they're the worst.
Never again.
I am probably in the biggest state of happiness I've been in like 4.5 months. Like, gym's open tomorrow. We're going to Pear Tree tomorrow. It's going to be insane. So I will catch you in the gym. So it's like 7 in the morning, I was up at 5:30, I was too awake, too excited, too buzzing. Before we head to the gym, before we head to lifts, I just have to say again, I've just made a post to my Instagram, but a massive thank you to every single one of you that are watching this video. You know, if someone had said to me my first year full time, you know, doing online coaching, that I would have to go through a global pandemic with 2 national lockdowns where gyms are closed the majority of the time and really trying to actually make it a success, I would have said there was no chance, being honest. But I just worked my arse off and luckily I've been able to work with some incredible people, and I'm still working with some incredible people that really have made this dream that I had throughout uni a reality. You know, I'm in a flat in Edinburgh, I'm living with someone, you know, who does a similar job to me, and we just bounce off each other, and Sophie's here, and it's all kind of like hitting me now, because the last 4 months, coming back from Seville, and moving to this new flat, and then going into a national lockdown again, was really tough. There were some great moments in there, but it was really tough, but we've came out of it, I'm better for it, and I'm just so happy. So thank you, honestly, from the bottom of my heart. Whether you've watched these videos regularly, whether you've just looked at some of my posts, whether you've been a client, thank you. Honestly, it means the world. But yeah, fuck it, let's get rid of this chat and let's just fucking go train in a proper gym. All the way to the gym and left my belt. Fuck's sake. So yeah, not the best, but you know what?
just going to forget about it. I'm too hyped, I don't care. You know, the belt doesn't make me. Going for my final walk, 180. Got 192.5 for, I want to say, 5 sets of 4. And then we're going to quads, deadlifts. Luckily, it's not too heavy today, so I should be fine. If it was anything over 200, it'd be a bit weird going for it out of my belt. But I think 11 weeks out from the clock now, so I'll fucking push it. Perfect time to get back in the gyms and really push the momentum that I've been building over the past while. So see how this 180 moves, beltless, and we'll just go from there. Conscious about my belt and using it, but that was so easy. Like the final sets, probably still like an RPE 6.5, maybe even just a 6. Moving on to deadlifts now, crossing at the knee. Working on that because normally with a pause deadlift, I pause like midway up my shin, but Martin's put that in so that I can work on my like, really keeping my grip and my lats tight as we get to the lockout portion of the movement. So I'm really focused on that. 6 sets of 3 with 195, and then just some excesses. But honestly, I think like the buzz of just being back in the gym made those squats fly. I didn't care if I didn't have a belt. Normally I'd be like,
fucking god. I am in a complete and utter state of euphoria right now. These endorphins are kicking in hard. What the fuck? I'm trying to record, mate. Fucking hell. Yeah, what a session, what a place, you know. Left my belt, but like the squats moved so well. Like, I don't think I've ever done more than like in around 180 with beltless, and I fucking smashed it, deads were fine as well. And I know going into this, like the next few weeks of this comp prep, that this place is going to like elevate me. Like I was speaking to people in there, the one guy, Mike, I was speaking to, he's competing in the same comp as me, but he's in the 83s, and I was speaking to Amy, someone who I like know through social media, who trains there, and we're chatting, and it's just like, oh, the fucking vibe, man, like, you can't not push yourself. Like, I didn't have my earphones in my end, the music ever hit, I just, fucking, big shout out to Andy, man, for Andy Smith for fucking putting that place together. I'm so happy that I can be in there consistently now, and I'm getting messages off clients who are just enjoying their first session. I hope you've all had a great first session, a great fucking, you know, good first day back in some sort of normality. Oh, I'm just fucking so over the moon. I've got Pear Tree booked there at 3 with Sophie in the beer garden. Oh, it's going to be so good. Just a few pints, a proper pint. Oh, yeah, so I'm going to go back, chill, do some work, and I'll catch up with yous later. There we go. Look at the beauty of it. Look at it.
Which one should I do first?
Guinness.
Oh, it's been a long 4.5 months. Oh, so fucking good. I'm so happy to be back, genuinely.
So, it's like 4 to 5, and something like that, a good couple of pints each. Place is busy, and we're meeting, bumped in some of our old course mates. Earlier, so we're going to their flat, and then they've got a booking later on at Indigo Yards, so we're going there too. I'm on my way. I wouldn't say I'm steaming yet, but I'm on my way, and I fucking love it. So happy everyone's back. Cheers to you. Love it.
It is the morning after, and I feel great, surprisingly. Went back to Lewis's flat, had some drinks there, and then went to Indigo Yard, which was nice, enjoyed that, and then just came back here. I mean, we were home by like, I want to say like 9:30-ish, and then in our beds for like 11, so we got a good sleep, and we also got like some like cheap Barocca type stuff, and tanned two of them, and I feel fine. I would never normally go train after drinking the day before, but like I said, I feel great, and I'm really wanting to hit this session, because I've got 147.5 bench single, pause bench single, which is obviously very close to my max of 150. So I'm hoping that this will move well enough that we know that I'm now better than like the 150 bench. So that's what I'm going for. But I'm going to sit and do some work first, maybe a coffee. And I've got a client to set up and a post tonight. So I'm going to get that done, then go train. I think she'll be seeing her friends later. But I'm just going to kind of like chill today and I might catch up with her later. But yeah, really, what a fucking brilliant day, first day of some normality coming back. Yeah, I'm just gonna do some work and I'll see you in the gym. Well, 147.5 moved really well. 147 RPE, like 7.5.
I think maybe I could have three more reps, but felt good, very smooth, no like stalling or anything. Once again, just to round off the video by saying like, hope you're all enjoying having some freedom back, being able to enjoy all the things we normally do. Hope you all smashed it in your sessions. And yeah, I'll catch you in the next video. Remember to leave a like, subscribe for now. And yeah, see you in the next one.